In recent news, floating robots and elephant seals joined a scientific research team to help solve a mystery about our polar seas. Okay, there are giant recurring holes called Polynyas that tend to pop up in both the Arctic and Antarctic that scientists just did not understand. And no, these aren't caused by the regular old melting of the ice caps. They're a long-standing, well-documented, mysterious, and surprising aspect of polar sea ice. They're essential to these ecosystems for many reasons, and are fascinating because under the circumstances, scientists would expect there to be a thick chunk of ice there, but there's not. Instead, there's a big hole opening into the ocean underneath. The Polynya these researchers studied in particular is an open ocean Polynya, meaning it vanishes every summer when the sea ice melts, and some years it'll randomly reappear in the same spot when the ice reforms, but sometimes not. And we know a little bit about how these kinds of Polynyas are maintained, but haven't known that much about how they form in the first place. The formation of this gaping hole that has ranged from the size of New Zealand to the size of South Carolina doesn't seem to be related to changes in temperature or other factors that would seem obvious. To explore the whole range of complex variables that could be at play in forming this Polynya, a research team at the University of Washington decided to analyze massive amounts of data that gave them a pretty comprehensive view of both the ocean and the ice for a period of several years. The essential tool in making this project happen? Floating robots. These novel bots are actually a really exciting tool being used in oceanography because they can remotely record all kinds of data. The temperature, salinity, ocean currents, and exciting new developments in biochemical sensor technology allow them to now take readings of oxygen and nitrogen levels, acidity, and lots of other complex biological and chemical factors. And they can dive a few kilometers below the ocean's surface, getting readings on what the ocean is like in the middle of winter when it would be too expensive and even dangerous for researchers to get there by boat. So why do we need the seals? Lest we forget, temperature, salinity, and other measurements were also gathered from elephant seals wearing sensors. Seals have access to the same parts of the ocean that the bots do, but the seals took data in years when the Polynya didn't show up and there was no hole in the ice. So the researchers could compare ocean conditions between years with and without Polynyas. As a result of all of this awesome data, the researchers found that increases in salinity and strong storm activity are likely the two formative factors for this mysterious Polynya. Both storms and increased salinity cause warmer water to rise to the surface and melt a hole in the ice. And the reason the Polynya keeps forming in the same place is because of the underwater topography. It's right above an undersea mountain. This traps that warm water there like a vortex, keeping the Polynya from closing back up. And if you're wondering what the seals thought about all this, sensors like this are attached using a special kind of glue that allows the sensor to fall off after a few months, after which the seals can go back to their day job of just being seals. Polynyas, besides being mysterious puzzles to oceanographers, are essential parts of polar ecosystems. They provide a bridge between ice and ocean for many polar animals like seals and penguins. Because they let sunlight into spots in the ocean that would otherwise be covered by ice, Polynyas provide ideal conditions for phytoplankton, which are the bottom link in the marine food chain. Everything else in the ocean depends on their existence. And Polynyas pour heat and moisture out of the sea and into the local atmosphere, changing the weather of their immediate vicinity. And climate change is associated with a decrease in ocean salinity and an increase in the severity and unpredictability of severe weather events, both of the factors that play a major role in Polynya formation. So while researchers don't know if the expected changes in climate will increase or decrease the instances of Polynyas, they're definitely pretty sure Polynya behavior will be disturbed, which may influence local weather patterns and ocean currents in ways that reverberate into the rest of the world's oceans and the wider climate patterns. And in order to understand just how this could affect Antarctic wildlife and sea ice dynamics, researchers say they can use results from studies like this to improve the models and simulations that help us know what to expect and how we can prepare. Want to know more about what's lurking under the ice at the bottom of the globe? Make sure you subscribe and check out this video on the dead continents underneath Antarctica over here. and keep coming back to Seeker for all your ocean science news. As always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.